Western Conference with this narrow victory over the Calgary Flames.
Season high, 6 wins in a row without their leading goal scorer and one of their best defensemen.
Let's get the goal. There's Andrew Ebbett scoring it.
The assist to number 6, Sami Salo. And number 3, Alex Edler.
Here's your scoring play. Canucks win it in overtime, and we're joined by a man who scored his first goal as a Canuck that allowed this game to get to overtime, Marc-Andre Gragnani. Just explain the celebration there at the end and how good you guys felt for Andrew Ebbett, who comes back and gets the winning goal.
Yeah, exactly. It was a big game for us. We came back in the third, and especially Ebbett getting the winner there is pretty good for him. He worked hard to get back from his injury.
Mark, congrats on the goal, and you had an assist last game as well. Your first point as a Canuck then. Was that a bit of a load off your shoulders?
Yeah. Obviously, coming here, and I haven't been on the score sheet too much in my first few games. Obviously, getting on the score sheet helped me a lot to get my confidence back, and hopefully keep going this way now.
How excited are you getting personally, and sort of can you give us a sense of the excitement around the team as you draw closer to the playoffs? That's where this team is going to prove itself if it's going to, and I imagine the guys are getting a little bit antsy.
Yes, of course. It's the reason we all play hockey. It's to get to the postseason, and obviously we have a great team, and we believe in ourselves. We're finishing the year very strongly now, so we're looking forward to the playoffs for sure.
Having any fun?
Yeah, I'm having a blast since I got here. I love the city, I love the fans. I love the team.
Hello everybody, and welcome to the Canucks.com post-game show. My name is Kathy Kovacs, and I am very happy to be your host for this first ever Canucks.com show. We are live from a very busy and excited Rogers Arena tonight, and I just want to mention that my colleague Joey Kenwood will also be here providing live reports from the bowels of Rogers Arena, the dressing rooms of both the Vancouver Canucks as well as the Calgary Flames on what was game number 79 for the Canucks of the regular season schedule, and what a game it was against the fledgling Calgary Flames. And for that, we will go to the highlights in case you missed it. Tonight at Rogers Arena, there is Roberto Luongo back between the pipes after missing the last game with a sore neck. Andrew Ebbett, the man of the night, and we'll explain why. First game back since breaking his collarbone back in January. Maxim Lapierre, that is why he is the hottest Canuck of the season. Talk about a happy birthday for him. Final seconds of the period, Dan Hampus with the point shot. Was post to post here. It is a close one, but no cigar. Look at that, it remained 1-0 after 2 as we go to the second period now, just 5 minutes in. Jerome Ginla finding Olli Jokinen, and that ties the game up at 1, and that is just his second goal in his last 11. 10 minutes later, the Canucks come that close to scoring, and then the third period, but less than a minute into the final frame, and that is, yes, yet another close call for the Canucks, as we mentioned. That kept it 1-1 as we go now into the third, and less than a minute into the frame, 51 seconds, in fact. What happened there? Roberto Luongo gets beat by Mike Camilleri, and the Flames take the first lead of the game. Luongo, though, bounces back nicely and making a couple saves, and then it would be the Canucks' turn one more time as they tie it up at 2. That is Marc-Andre Gagnani with just a second of the season. Yet more close calls, narrow escapes. Henrik Sedin with the assist on that one as he now has 8 points in his last 6 games. And then, of course, they go into extra time. And they are, that was the game winner for the Vancouver Canucks. And that made it a 3-2 win. That was Andrew Ebbett's game-winning goal. And now we will throw it down to Joey Kenward for his post-game highlights.
You know, we want to make sure that we take care of business. So, huge win for us tonight, no doubt.
How about your performance today?
Yeah, no, I felt good. I think the boys played really well in front of me. Nothing, you know, as far as too dangerous as far as scoring chances and odd man rushes, and you know, a good job clearing the lane. So, you know, we played a good game. We were patient, and you know, once again, we found a way to win.
Roberto, Andrew Ebbett's had a tough couple of months here. Roberto, sorry, whoever I cut off there, but he's had a tough few months, hasn't he? And to get the game winner and get mobbed by his teammates like that.
Yeah, it's nice. I mean, first game back, you know, to score a huge goal like that, you know, must be an unreal feeling for him. And he's got a knack to score big goals. I mean, remember the one in San Jose in OT earlier in the year. So coach is not scared to put him out there.
When did you guys learn of the St. Louis result? And, I mean, was it talked about in here?
Yeah, after the second, I think we were aware that they had lost. So, you know, obviously it was a huge period for us coming in. And we wanted to obviously get the win and be in first place. So we found a way to get her done, and it's a nice win for the boys.
Roberto Luongo talking with members of the media. We're going to head over to one of the goal scorers in tonight's game. In fact, he's had a hot hand the past couple of outings here for the Canucks. Max Lapierre had 3 points against Dallas last night and catches in with a goal this evening here in the win over Calgary.
Be physical, and but right now I'm having a fun time.
I think what you bring to a line particularly picked Hemric up somehow. I mean, it's like as soon as you get on there, he suddenly was himself again, you know?
Well, I don't think so. I think this guy works so hard every game, and it's not because they're not making points or goals that they're not doing their job. I mean, they work really hard. They're great players, so obviously the other team are playing at the best of their game when they're on the ice, but it was just a matter of time before they score some goals.
Talk a little bit about your goal, Max, how it came about tonight.
To be honest, just went to the net and got an unreal pass by Henrik. I mean, I just had to put my stick on the ice, and that's all I had to do.
How nice is it to see Andrew Ebbett be rewarded for his efforts tonight? That's been quite a couple of months he's had to go through personally, both on and off.
Yeah, he's an unreal guy. I mean, this is the type of teammate you want in your team. He's the type of guy that comes in the rink, whatever he plays or whatever he's injured, he's bringing a smile at the rink, and he's working hard with probably the hardest every day, and he deserves that. This is the type of player that deserves goals like that.
This is the longest winning streak you guys have had all season. This is about as good as the team has felt attitude-wise as you come together into the final week of the campaign.
Well, I think our goal is to get better every day until the playoffs. I mean, we know we didn't play our best games lately, but we see improvement every game, and we'll be ready for first game in the playoffs.
Thanks, Mike.
Thank you.
Max Lapierre with a goal tonight. We're going to catch up with Marc-Andre Gragnani. He had a goal tonight for Vancouver, his first in a Canucks uniform, his second goal of the season. He's met with the majority of the media here, just taking off a few of his shin guards and knee braces here. And Mark, if we can catch you here right now, if you can just maybe talk a little bit about getting that first goal in a Canucks uniform. It proved to be a pretty big one tonight, didn't it, to tie this game up with the Flames at 2?
Yeah, it was a nice goal. I think we deserved a goal on that shift. The forwards worked really hard. We were in the offensive zone for about a minute. And I got a good pass from Burrows, and luckily it went in.
Feel nice to get that first goal under your belt. I know it's been a few weeks since you've been with the team since being acquired at the trade deadline.
Yeah, and especially to get out at home in front of our fans was pretty special for me. I'm happy I got it, and I'm more happy about the win.
You guys have won 6 in a row. You're officially in top spot in the Western Conference to enter the final week of the regular season. Can you just talk a little bit about the morale inside this locker room?
Yeah, I think everyone is happy. I mean, 6 straight wins is hard in this league. We worked for it, and we're going for 7 next game.
Thanks, Mark. Congratulations.
No problem. Thank you.
Marc-Andre Gragnani with the goal tonight to get this game into overtime. And we'll take a quick break. We'll throw back to you, Kathy. We'll catch up with the game-winning overtime hero in just a moment.
Thank you. We are looking forward to that. And Andrew Ebbett must be a happy person indeed, of course. Hasn't played since January 7th when he broke his collarbone against the Boston Bruins. He's missed a ton of games. He gets back into the lineup finally. And what does he do? He ends up scoring. And it has been, no doubt, a big, big game for him, a big night as well for the Canucks in general on what was game 79 of the regular season against the Flames. The Canucks pull it off 3-2, at 3-2 in overtime. Roberto Luongo back after missing last game against the Dallas Stars, and Luongo looked great. In certain points here, making saves as he screened here. He goes down but manages to come up against a lot of Calgary Flames pressure throughout this hockey game at times. The shots were pretty much dead even throughout the entire contest. We were giving away a little bit of rebounds there, but still rising to the occasion, getting some help as well there from his defensive corps. And in the end, it does produce a well-deserved win for the Vancouver Canucks here at Rogers Arena tonight against the Calgary Flames, who are all but done in this regular season. They will not be advancing to the postseason. In fact, as it stands right now, just the Canucks and the Ottawa Senators, the only Canadian teams who will be in the postseason. So we've got a lot more coverage here tonight. We are now joined by the man who scored the game winner, Andrew Ebbett.
Thank you very much, Kathy. Well, let's talk a little bit about your OT winner and something that I think you might be getting used to. Second time this year you've helped the team clinch a victory in OT.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's like kind of the icing on the cake for tonight. I'm just happy to be back with the guys and back playing and to play the full game and be back healthy.
Describe the game-winning goal for us.
Not really sure. I just went to the front of the net. Sammy got the puck and he had his head up the whole way and took kind of a half slap shot, and it caught my stick and got lucky and went in.
What's the past few days been like for you? I know when we talked to you last week, you thought that you might be a little bit further away from getting back into game mode, but it seemed like things might have turned a corner rehab-wise in the past few days.
Yeah, I think about 5-6 days ago it kind of turned the corner and I started to feel where I was back to normal, and then it's just getting back with the doctor, talking to him one-on-one, and Wednesday night he kind of came in and gave me his vote of confidence, and I think that was huge for me to be able to go the next day and tell coach that I was ready to go.
And to return to the lineup when the team is on its longest win streak of the season and now atop the Western Conference, you probably couldn't ask for much better personally, could you?
Yeah, I was actually a little worried last night with the big win if I was going to get in tonight with the way the guys have been playing, because sometimes, you know, coaches don't want to mess with the lineup, but we don't have many games left, and I think he wants to get me in there for the playoffs and kind of a couple dress rehearsals kind of thing, and it was just great to get back, and the way the team's playing, it was made it easy for me.
Great to see you back, Andrew. Congratulations on the win.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Andrew Ebbett, the OT winning hero for the Vancouver Canucks. We'll take a break. Kathy, throw it back to you. We're going to head over to the training room side of the Canucks facilities here at Rogers Arena and get a couple more exclusive interviews following this OT victory over Calgary.
Thank you very much, Joey. Yes, the training room area is always a busy spot, especially as we inch towards the playoffs, whether it's upper body injuries or lower body injuries. Who knows what's going to happen with the likes of the Kevin Bieksa and, of course, Daniel Sedin. But they did have, as you saw, Andrew Ebbett back in the lineup, and a very modest young man talking about how happy he was and relieved to be back in the lineup with that. So now with the... With Maxim Lapierre, what we were saying earlier, this guy has been on fire. He just turned 27 the other day, and his birthday present was none other than Coach AD saying, hey, guess what? You're going to be on the top line. You're going to be playing along Henrik and Alex Edler, and it has reaped major benefits. 4 points in the last two games, 3 points against the Dallas Stars, and then again, a big goal tonight again for number 40, Maxim Lapierre. So congratulations to him and his teammates in what was a 3-2 overtime win against the Calgary Flames. That, more interestingly than anything, puts the Canucks ahead of St. Louis in the overall standings. So Vancouver now has 107 points overall in the Western Conference. That is good enough for top spot in the West, a coveted spot that they've been clawing back at, trying to get at for some time now. And we are glad to go back down to GM Place, where Sami Salo is standing by with Joey Kenward.
Thanks very much, Kathy. Well, Sammy, can you talk a little bit about how this game started for your hockey club to jump out to the lead, but then you saw a pretty good pushback from your opponents to finish off that first period?
Yeah, it was a typical game against the Calgary Flames. You know, both teams fought really hard, and a lot of big battles, a lot of one-on-one battles, and very close game right till the end. And that's what we've seen. I've seen all the years that I've been here against Calgary Flames. You know, they play a really hard, simple game, and usually it's just the team that finds a way to win is usually coming out on top.
You know, on any given night, you can look, it seems, to any player on this roster to find a big goal or two, and tonight you look to a guy like Marc-Andre Gragnani from defense, and then Andrew Ebbett with the OT clean.
Yeah, I think that's been the key lately, is getting contribution from everybody, and that's going to be a key heading into the playoffs for sure. You know, you need four good lines, three good deep pairings to get that scoring opportunities for everybody.
What does it mean to enter the final week of the season in top spot in the Western Conference now with just three games remaining?
Well, I think aside from that thing, I don't think it matters too much. I think we want to prepare ourselves in the last three games to put our game in the right spot. And, you know, we have still little issues that we want to
obviously fine-tune heading into the playoffs.
And having won six in a row, your longest win streak of the season, is this about as confident you've seen this group all year long?
I don't know. You know, we've played some pretty good hockey, but like I said, there's still areas that we want to be better.
Thanks, Sammy. Congratulations. Sami Salo following the overtime victory here tonight against the Calgary Flames. You can see a few of the players continuing to cool down after the victory here against Calgary. We're going to take a quick timeout here inside the locker room. Kathy, we'll throw it back to you in just moments away from hearing from head coach Alain Vigneault at the press conference room.
Thank you very much, Joey. Great to hear from Sami Salo. Of course, he had a big goal against the Dallas Stars last night, and total team effort tonight for the Canucks against the Calgary Flames. Seeing some scoring from some fairly unlikely sources, but also some great chances. Chris Higgins continues to be hot, although he didn't score, though, but he did hit a couple of posts behind the rookie Henrik Karlsson in place for Mika Kiprusoff. So the Canucks looking good as they inch into the home stretch. As Joey said, winners out of their last six. If they run the tables here, who knows, they could go nine straight as they wrap up the end of the regular season, as they look towards the playoffs, which will begin the second week of April. Their next game, though, will be this Tuesday when they play host to the fledgling Anaheim Ducks. So a lot of interesting stuff happening in Canucks Nation, notably with Luongo coming back and holding his ground in overtime. And Andrew Ebbett was the big story of the evening as he comes back after breaking his collarbone months ago, January 7th, and getting the job done with a minute and 2 seconds left in overtime. And he scored the game winner for the Canucks to leave a lot of fans going home very happy tonight. And we now go back down to Joey Kenward, who's standing by between the two dressing rooms. Joey.
Yeah, thanks very much, Kathy. You mentioned this being the longest winning streak the Canucks have had all season long, six straight. They are the hottest team right now in the NHL. And with that extra point tonight over Calgary, they do vault past the St. Louis Blues by one single point, entering their final three games of regular season action. They'll be back here at Rogers Arena Tuesday when the Anaheim Ducks come to town. Vancouver then will play its final road game of the campaign against the same Calgary Flames at the Saddle Dome next Thursday, and then they'll cap off the regular season with a home ice finale against the Edmonton Oilers. So against three teams that pretty much, although I don't know if Calgary is completely mathematically eliminated at this point, but for all intent and purposes, the last three games Vancouver will play will be against teams that will be on the outside looking in come playoff time. So they don't want to take anything for granted, and they can't think that those are games that are just 2 points in the bag. Those will be tough points to get if they want to be able to clinch a Western Conference, and you never know, if they can take care of business and get some help along the way from teams out in the Eastern Conference, they might be able to capture their second straight President's Trophy. Kathy?
You can bet that'll be on the minds of many tonight as they talk about this victory. Whether or not the Canucks want to vie for the President's Trophy, they'll never admit that. They won't touch a trophy unless, of course, it is Lord Stanley's Cup. It's all good as they get set to go to the coach, Alain Vigneault.
Through some challenging circumstances this year, a couple of injuries that have held him back, but to see him battle the way he did to get healthy, and you know, that nobody was sure if he'd be able to come back this year and be able to contribute, and he found a way to get himself healthy, and a couple of games remaining come into the lineup, and tonight you know, pushed his way up into the lineup minutes, and was able to get us a big goal in OT.
What about the push you guys came with in the back half of that third period?
Yeah, I mean, we were down by one goal, and you know, we trying to tie it up, and our guys battled hard. Did a lot of credit. They came in here and they played a real solid game. They were strong in the areas that they needed to be. And at 2-1, our goaltender made three big saves there to keep us in, and gave us an opportunity to tie it, win it in overtime.
You got some help on the out-of-town scoreboard. How much was that a factor on the bench when you talked about it?
Well, it was certainly a factor in the coach's office. You know, when we were watching St. Louis's game and weren't quite sure what the score was after the first, found out that they had lost. But our players knew before we had to tell them. So, you know, we're a point ahead right now, and we're not going to change our approach or our focus. We're going to take a day off tomorrow, have a good practice on Monday, and get ready for Tuesday.
Two-thirds of your second line didn't play towards the end of the game in overtime. How concerned are you about the scoring, lack of scoring?
Right now, you know, those guys are going to have a day off. They're going to have a good practice on Monday, and they're going to focus on Tuesday. That's what they need to do.
You sat Sammy a couple times in the last road trip. Are you any closer to getting Kevin or Rome back in a week or so? Are you comfortable playing Sammy the rest of the way?
Well, I thought, you know, 4-6 is always very challenging, and this was 8-13. That's extremely challenging. For any player, for any team. I thought we handled it real well. In this case, we only have 6 healthy Ds right now. So the benefit was the 4 games were at home. So we didn't have to travel. We didn't have that fatigue factor. But if we would have had 1 healthy defenseman that I could have used, I might have given him one of these 2 back-to-backs off. But he's a big boy. He's a veteran player. He knows how to play, and he did a good job tonight.
What do you think has allowed him to play in back-to-backs this year? A lot of us thought maybe while they got to sit Sammy, it's back-to-backs yet.
Stubborn coach? I don't know. Yeah, maybe. I mean,
he says he doesn't like to sit.
Yeah, I think, you know, those calls were my calls, and I'm not sure that he's crazy about that. He wouldn't probably come out and tell me, you know, he's a real pro, and he said, yeah, yes, coach, whatever you want. But I think he prefers to play, and my job is to look at the big picture. So,
is that an example of Gragnani following the coach's orders to pinch and shoot?
Not really. I mean, all our Ds, not just him, but all our Ds have that read that they have to be able to make. I mean, that's what makes our team good both offensively and defensively. As a defenseman and as a forward, you got to be able to make those reads. He made the right read, and he was rewarded with the tying goal.
Max Lapierre story's been a nice one the last couple of nights, but I think from an organizational standpoint, it's even more important to get Henrik the playmaker back.
Max is Henrik's playmaker? Or no,
Henrik's
send him
off.
Okay, yeah.
Max's finisher, and
yeah.
He seems for goal.
Yeah,
Henrik
setting. Well, yeah, I mean, Henrik, I think prior to him setting up in the last 2 games, I still think he was the number one assist getter in the National Hockey League. That's pretty good. But I think for Hank going forward, even without his brother right now, for him to be able to get on the score sheet is a very positive thing. And, you know, he made some nice plays tonight, making some saucers right to the net. In OT there, I think it was Chris Higgins that had a great chance and a great A chance, and he did the same thing to set up Max.
For a while there was talk that maybe, you know, winning the President's Trophy or even the West wasn't all that important in the grand scheme of things. Now the players seem pretty motivated to hang on to the lead in the West and maybe pass New York for the President's Trophy. Is that something nice to have as you head into the last week of the season? Something to battle for?
You know, throughout, I don't think our approach has changed. I mean, we've been focused on, you know, one game at a time. We've been trying to put our best foot forward every game. Sometimes, some nights it's prettier than others. Some nights it's more entertaining than others. But the one thing about this team is it works real hard. It prepares itself real well. Just look at the way we usually start games. I think we're the best in the NHL that way. And you know, some nights that you know, might not be as pretty as others, but our focus is on a game-to-game basis, trying to do our best and trying to win hockey games, trying to find ways to win hockey games, and that's what this group does. Do I have the Francais coming up? Wait.
Well, there is the winning coach, Alain Vigneault, of course, with the Vancouver Canucks, who posted a 3-2 overtime win over the Calgary Flames. The Flames in town and just playing out the season pretty much, as they are almost mathematically eliminated from the postseason. As we said, you heard from the winning coach. Now it's time to hear from the losing coach, Calgary's Brent Sutter.
Well, you know, I thought, you know, we played hard. You know, you have a lead 2-1 with, you know, what was it, down to 7-8 minutes left to go in the hockey game, and you gotta, you know, close the deal on it. You know, we turn the puck over in the neutral zone, and we turn it over in our own zone, and next thing you know, it's in our net, and you know, it's a 2-1 score, and you know, again, it's a tough way to give up a lead when when you're up like that, and basically we played pretty well up to that point.
What were your thoughts on Henrik Karlsson finally getting a start in the Nets?
Well, he hadn't played in a while. You know, he's he made some really good saves, and I'm sure he'd probably like to have a couple of the goals back. So, you know, he hadn't played in a long time, so, you know, you're not sure exactly how he's going to perform, but, you know, I thought that, he was okay.
Coach, at San Jose, Dallas tonight, those two teams play again, so there's guaranteed 2 points that they're going to get. This will put you out, I believe, tonight, if I've done the math right.
You know what? We came in here tonight mathematically still alive, but knowing our chances were very slim. Our focus was to win the hockey game, and again we came up short in overtime.
Could you put your finger in it just down the stretch, Brent, what went sideways for you guys, or Jerome, or talk about maybe he or other guys that managed to come through later, or what would you say?
You know what? There's going to be lots of time to sit back and evaluate what's gone on here, and obviously it's worse than being disappointed, I'll tell you that. And we got ourselves in a position to battle for playoff spots, and for a playoff spot, and it was us and with four other teams, and we never got the job done. The last 8 games and 9 games now, you win 1 game in regulation, and it's not going to be good enough. And we didn't play as well as we needed to down the stretch, and tonight's game, and then probably in the last 3, was our best game out of the last 3, and the other 2 games were pretty significant games for us. So, but I don't know what else you want me to say.
That is literally a man at a loss for words, and not often smiling, of course, not much to smile about this season in general, let alone tonight. Of course, Joey Kenward joining us upstairs here, your opinion?
Yeah, you know what, Calgary, for all intent and purposes, were pretty much out of the playoff picture even before this night started. They had to win their final 3 games without giving up points to their opponents, and hope that they had great help around the Western Conference picture for those teams bouncing around that 8, 9, 10, 11 spot. Didn't happen. Still not officially mathematically eliminated, but that's a frustrating night, I'm sure, for the visiting coach when his team had a 1-goal lead on the road into the third period.
Absolutely. Does not happen very often. And this is one of the men who helped stop the Calgary Flames. And there is Andrew Ebbett back in action since January 7th. His first game, first period, the red hot Max Lapierre. 3 points last night. And then look what he does here as he scores his 8th goal of the season. That made it 1-0 Van City. Nicely done. Talk about a happy birthday gift for him on the top line. Final seconds of the second. Dan Hamm, here's his point shot. Goes post to post off of Henrik Karlsson's pipes. 1-0 after 2. And just 5 minutes into the middle frame, Jerome McGinley finds Olli Jokinen. That's just his 2nd goal in his last 11 games, as the score is now tied 1-1. And then 10 minutes later, the Canucks come oh so close. Chris Higgins looking for the back of the net. It looks like he finds it, but when you look at it a little bit closer, that did not go over the line. Karlsson does manage to make a save as it does not go in. But then third period, less than a minute into the final frame, just like that, Mike Camilleri scoring his 18th of the season. That gives the visitors the first lead of the hockey game. A lot of pushing and shoving going along the boards there midway through the third period. And that is a nice goal. His first as a Canuck, 2nd of the season. Marc-Andre Gragnani, thank you very much, they say, as that ties it all up. And we go into overtime. And that would be Andrew Ebbett with the marker. Just a minute 2 left in the extra frame. And that is the celebrated goal at Rogers Arena as he beats Henrik Karlsson with a Salo with the slap shot there. And then it was Andrew Ebbett with the game winner. Not bad for a guy who hasn't played since the 7th of January. Man, did he ever look happy with you?
Absolutely. And boy, you just see all those face washes his teammates were giving him after the victory. Guy that deserves everything he's been getting. Absolutely. Right now. Had a tough go of it even earlier on in the season when he had scored a game in Los Angeles and then had a broken foot. Verified right after that, comes back into the lineup, had some goals. I know he had a 2-goal effort here in this building against Edmonton, and then goes to Boston, shatters his collarbone, gets back into the mix tonight. And more importantly for him, yes, he gets the overtime winner, but he does get back into game mode, and he does get a chance to
show what Alain Vigneault can see out of him in the final week. They want to get him some reps here before the playoffs roll around.
Absolutely, and with all the players injured and, you know, nursing injuries, it'll be a nice welcome to have a big bullpen like that that they can go to in the postseason.
Absolutely.